How to limit file history disk usage. Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. File history is a convenient feature in both Windows 10 and 11 that will essentially use a disk as kind of an ongoing backup. Every few minutes, it checks for changes in files that you have been working on, and if such a file has changed, then a copy of it is quickly made to this disk. Now, there's a lot of configuration associated with file history. You can tell it how often and what disk to use and even what folders to pay attention to. However, the one thing that it doesn't apparently let you do is limit the space it uses, regardless of all those other options. So I ran across an interesting technique, though, that actually will force file history to limit how much disk space it uses, and I want to show you what that's like. So we'll start by firing up Control Panel, which, by the way, is still around. All you really need to do is search for it. And in Control Panel, you'll see Save Backup Copies of Your Files with File History. We'll click on that. It is now searching for drives that it could use for file history. I've currently got it turned off. So step one, well, will not be to turn it on. What I'm going to do instead is look at the disks I have in my system. You'll notice that it's giving me the option to use my second drive. That could be a second internal drive. It could be an external drive. But the point is, it's a second drive. And by default, file history will use, if need be, all the space on that drive. Not quite what we want. So let's go take a look at what our disks look like. I'm firing up, right-clicking on the Start menu and firing up Disk Management. What we're going to do is take that second drive and turn it into two partitions. So you can see here I've got second drive. It is 128 gigabytes of space. What we're going to do is shrink it. Shrink the volume. So what we're going to do is decide how much space we want to allocate to file history. In my case, I'm just going to say 32 gigabytes. So in that case, that means here, 32,000, roughly, and hit shrink. Now I have this unallocated drive over here, this unallocated space that is available for other things. I'll right-click on it, call it a new simple volume. I will go ahead and use all of the available space there. We can assign it a drive letter, and I'm actually going to give it a volume label that says disk for file history. Quick format is fine. NTFS is appropriate. We'll click on next. We'll click on finish. And now all of a sudden we have drive F available to us. Now, if we return over here, we'll go over and click on select drive. This then gives me the three options in this case that I could use for file history. What I'm going to do is use this disk for file history. That will then be dedicated to file history. I'll click on OK. We'll click on Turn On. And now file history is working, but it will never use more than the 32 gigabytes that I've allocated to the drive it's been assigned. That means that it will never impinge on whatever else is on that physical hard drive. The original partition, partition D in this case, second drive in this example, will never run into out-of-space problems due to file history. So that is an interesting approach that, like I said, I discovered not that long ago to really rein in what file history may or may not do. Now, of course, there are other options to controlling file history, and I've got those described in a different article and video, but they boil down to restricting which folders it's going to pay attention to, restricting how long it will keep files in history, and then also adjusting how often it will copy things to file history. But this way, regardless of what those settings happen to be, we've set up an absolute upper limit, in my case, of 32 gigabytes. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/182266. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.